the Keto Glo Up. Hi friends. So it's legit been over a month since I made my last video. In all honesty, I haven't had the mental capacity to like sit in front of a camera and just talk. And I very much don't want to be one of those people on YouTube who like, everything is great and life is dandy. And then all of a sudden they're like making a video about depression. Not saying that I'm depressed necessarily, but like when you're dealing with so many different things at once, it's just really hard to like find that emotional constancy. And while I'm not at 100% by any means, I do feel like I'm making progress in that direction. And so, I don't know where I was going with that thought. I'm whatever. But this will be a cook and chat video. Probably less chatting and more cooking. I'm gonna do keto bagels using the fathead method. And if you're unfamiliar, it's the same method I use to make my pizzas. Essentially, you melt mozzarella, mix in cream cheese.
Okay, kitty.
Mix in cream cheese, almond flour, usually baking powder, depending on what. My cat is being super weird all of a sudden. He was quiet the whole time I was like setting everything up, and now he's all meowlicious. Anyway, depending on what thing you're actually making will depend on what other things go into said dough, but for the purposes of the bagels, it'll be the two cheeses, possibly some seasoning, almond flour, baking powder, salt, eggs. I don't think I'm missing anything else. Shout out to my skin for the, I guess, glow up. Does that, I felt gross saying the glow up on the Keto Glo Up channel. Anyway, this is another thing that I've been working on. Like, I've been using collagen powder in my coffee in the morning, because MCT oil was making my throat feel weird. And I don't think it was an allergy. I think it was just a mix of having really hot coffee with oil mixed into it and then like heavy cream, whatever. And so I switched to, I believe the brand is called Keto, K-E-Y-T-O. It could be a lie. It could just be the name of whatever the powder. And I've been using that collagen powder in my coffee. I actually ran out and then switched to something else, to MCT powder. I actually have it right here. Ugh, iPad's in the way. And this is just MCT oil powder. This does not have collagen in it. But I did notice that when I was using the collagen powder, at first I was like, eh, not really noticing a difference. I was looking more so at my hair, but my nails and my skin, have cleared up significantly. And so I'm not really feeling this that much. The taste is okay. It's unsweetened. I'm not crazy about it though. It's also this really weird powdery. Like it looks like confectioner sugar. And so like when I'm scooping, it just does a dust cloud and it's all over the place and it's disastrous for me. Sorry. My alarm is going off. Alexa, stop. I don't know where it's going off from. The office? Sure. Anyway, so I am going to stop talking and I'm going to hop into this video. And Happy New Year and Merry Christmas, right? Because early December was the last video. Happy all of the things that have been celebrated between December 1st and today. I believe today's the 20th of January. It is. Forgive me, I will do better. And I still owe y'all some videos that I said I was gonna do, including my kitchen gadgets and some shopping things, and I'll probably do some type of shopping hauls just so you can see like what exactly I'm eating aside from the things that I make in these videos. So let's hop over and make some bagels.
Okay, so the recipe I'm following is from the Novice Chef blog. There's a ton of very similar recipes for keto bagels out there. This one uses the fathead dough sort of recipe, and if you're unfamiliar, it's essentially several different types of cheeses melted together, mixed with almond flour, baking powder, so on and so forth, depending on what you're making. It's the same recipe that I used to do my pizzas, and I will probably do a video on that at some point. Actually, I was originally going to do that one, but I really don't feel like pizza this week, and so I'm going to do bagels, because I kind of miss bagels. Anyway, and so my oven is already preheated to 425. As you can see, I'm following the recipe on my iPad. Anyway, so I've got my Sargento, low moisture, part scam mozzarella. I know everything keto recipe always says to use full fat, blah, blah, blah. But I don't think you can find low moisture that isn't part skim. And it's really important that you use the low moisture. Otherwise, things don't hold together the way they're supposed to. Anyway, so the first part of the recipe says 2.5 cups of shredded mozzarella cheese. I am going to pray to God that I actually have a full 2.5 cups. Because I've just been sprinkling mozzarella in my egg in the morning and did not fully think about needing it for recipes this weekend. Ugh. I freaking hate dry measuring. Or like semi-dry measuring. I don't really know what to call it. It's always a pain. I get cheese. Look, I've already got cheese on the table. It's 1 cup. This looks like a 1/2 cup. Oh, this pack's not even open yet. Ha ha ha. I think I'm okay with you. I think I'm okay. So while I fight to get this bag open, in the past, I'm not even sure how many weeks it's been since I made the last video, but as y'all should know, my starting weight was 180. I am currently at 161.7. And so I did not hit my goal of 160 by the new year, but it's fine. I did have some minor setbacks, and by minor setbacks, I mean brunch, where I did have like, I had two biscuits, like regular Pillsbury biscuits, and then also Christmas, I had a decent amount of carbs, which kind of just led to me fasting the next day. That was the second cup, by the way. I'm working on the half. And so I spent most of my like holiday break kind of teetering between being in ketosis and not being in ketosis, and I knew it. But the mental state I was in, I was like, I don't even care right now. I just really need some comfort food that isn't something covered in cheese or a fat bomb or whatever. I am fully back in ketosis now. I have been doing a significantly better job of avoiding carbs like I was not doing before. I just got Happy Farms cream cheese. I got this from Aldi. My last set of shopping was from Aldi, and their stuff is significantly cheaper than like Food Town or wherever. I do a large amount of my shopping from either Costco or BJ's, depending on which store has the things I need. And just buying in bulk is cheaper, especially for like meats and these bags of mozzarella. All right, for the cream cheese, it says 3 ounces cubed. I am not cubing anything. These have the nice markers. So this is 2 ounces, 3 ounces. So I'm just gonna take a knife and cut straight down this line and dump this in here. Anyway, so all these stuff
tends to be cheaper. Hi, kitty.
But the quality's a little sketchy. So I got some salmon fillets in, I don't remember how many are in the pack. When I took it out and I defrosted it and then I went to cook it yesterday, it just looked kind of sketch. And so I'm not really sure where they get their fish from. Like, it tasted fine. It just looked weird to me in comparison to, like, when you go out and you get salmon, or even when you just get it from, like, BJ's or Costco, it just didn't look the same and made me a little nervous. I would rather just spend the money that I didn't really want to spend on getting legit looking salmon or just fish in general from a reputable source. But I ain't die and my stomach doesn't hurt, so I guess it's fine. Alright, so here's the mozzarella and the 3 ounces of cream cheese. I did not cube it. I don't know why it even says to cube it. It doesn't help you mix or anything. Because this still has to go in the microwave and be melted. So I'm going to pop this in the microwave and I'll be back with melty cheese.
A few moments later.
Alright, so this was in the microwave for a minute. I also had the cream cheese out on the table for a while just to get to room temperature so it wouldn't be wicked hard and hard to mix. And you're just going to mix this into some semblance of, I don't know, till it doesn't look like it's two different cheeses just mashed together. And if at any point this gets too hard to mix, I just pop it back in the microwave. So this is a minute. I'll pop it back in for another 30 or so seconds. Oh god, this is hard. And it's harder for me because my table is high and I'm not tall, and so I actually have to keep my arm at this angle. Alright, so the recipe says place mozzarella and cream cheese in a bowl, microwave for 2 minutes, stirring halfway through, which I did not do, but whatever. Stir again, and then let the mixture cool until you can handle touching it. It does not take that long in my microwave. I don't know if other folks' microwave are just that trash that you have to, like, heat it to the point of you can't even touch it. Okay. And then just use your spatula to get cheese from around in the bottom of the bowl back in here. Not wasting any of my cheese. Alright. Next bit says to add your flour mixture and 2 eggs to the melted cheese mixture and then knead it with your hands. This is always, I'm glad that it says knead it with your hands, because every other fathead recipe I've seen, like, continuously tells you to use the spatula, or if you have like a stand mixer to do it in the stand mixer. First of all, stand mixers cost like $300 and something or $200 and something if you find it on sale. Anybody got time to be spending that kind of money to be mixing cheese mush? Anyway, so I am using my Red Mill Superfine Almond Flour, and it calls for 1.5 cups. Oh, they changed the thing on here. Or is this not the bag I had before? I'm not really sure. So it's resealable, but it has strips on it that are like, you can see that. It has strips on it that are like Velcro closed together, as opposed to an annoying zipper thing that may or may not actually be closed. Anyway. Alright, so I'm gonna do this in a separate bowl because this was supposed to have been mixed with the baking soda already.
I mean baking powder. Baking powder. Dear Lord, do not put baking soda in there.
Alright, so I'm gonna grab a new bowl and do 1.5 cups of almond flour. Cheese in here. I'm also kind of eyeball measuring for the sake of not spending all my time measuring this out. That's one. Whoop. That's about half. Don't make fun of my faulty measuring. It has not failed me
so far, anyway. I'm just going to use a whisk
to get the lumps out of here because it's significantly easier to mix in with the cheese if you've gotten rid of the lumps.
My camera's super rude and cut off while I was talking. Anyway, all right.
So almond flour all mixed up. I'm going to add the tablespoon of baking powder. Again, powder, not soda. I'm just using the generic, Whole Foods brand. And I just like to scrape it against the edge to make sure that it's a fairly level amount. It also says to mix in garlic, salt, and pepper. I do not own garlic salt, and I'm actually out of garlic powder because when I ordered my groceries, it was allegedly out of stock. I don't know how garlic powder would be out of stock. There's several different brands, but whatever y'all say. Anyway, mix that well. You don't want some of your bagels to be soft and fluffy and other parts of it to be weird and lumpy. Since I don't have garlic salt, I'm just gonna toss in a half teaspoon of regular fine ground sea salt. Again, generic 365 brand. Nothing fancy. That is not a half a teaspoon. Alright, just. That was sketchy, wasn't it? It's fine. I'm not cooking in a restaurant for public people. It's just me eating this by my lonesome. Alright, I think that's efficient. Get my bowl back of cheese over here. Oh my god, that is my cat's feeder. Well, I feel like, no, I guess the last time it went off was like 5 a.m. Alright, so this had time to get a little hard, so I'm going to pop it back in the oven for 30 seconds. Oven. Microwave for 30 seconds. And then mix it in. Started to make some hot bubbly noises. That was a little scary. Anyway. Alright, here we go. Back to soft. I'm just gonna mush a little opening. Pour everything out into this bowl. I'm gonna just do a prelim mix with the spatula. Get as much as that of that mixed in before I go sticking my hand in here. Almond flour ends all up under your nails. And then once I add the egg, it's just gonna be a wet mess. This does require a little muscle. So, if you don't have any, you might want to get somebody else to do it for you. I've got two regular eggs, nothing fancy. I don't even think it's free range. I'm not going to pretend like I care. Just scroll up a little. I'm sure there's a difference. I'm sure some version of egg is better for you than others, but I think I said this before, if your budget does not call for organic, free-range, cage-free, non-GMO, blah-bitty-blah, don't freaking go out of your way to buy it. Like, you can do keto and stay within a decent budget range and still lose the weight and still hit your goals and still meet your macros. Like, don't go breaking your wallet just to be whatever your goal weight is. Like, I also feel like when you watch some of these folks' videos and they're like, oh, I bought this organic cow-free milk. And it's just the most magical thing, and you must buy it. It will, like, make you feel like this isn't a thing you should even attempt to do. And you shouldn't feel that way. Because some uppity whoever told you that you need to buy that specific thing. Anyway, that's my pep talk for you. Just gonna crack these eggs up in here. Y'all see that? No shell. No shell in my eggs. But I am gonna go back to using this to mix this in though. All right, so you're gonna continue to mix this. Eventually I'm gonna stick my hand back in here, but it's just easier for me to do it this way first. Until it looks like one consistent lump of dough. So it'll turn egg yolk yellow, obviously, but like you want it to be egg yolk yellow throughout, and you want that egg to be well mixed in. And this is with any fathead dough recipe. Like, it doesn't really matter what the folks say as far as like your mixing time. You want this to mix well. Otherwise, you end up with a hot disaster. And your food just won't taste good. And it won't look good. And it's not going to hold together the way it's supposed to hold together. And you're going to wonder what you did wrong. And it's because you didn't incorporate everything together properly. So keep mixing. And if you think you've mixed enough, mix a little more. Very warm, and so it's very sticky and it'll be hard to divide it into, I think this makes six, so it'll be hard to make it into six with the way that it is right now. I'm gonna let it cool a little so the cheese will harden and it'll be easier to roll out and section and all that good stuff. Okay. So I got caught up in some Twitter foolishness, and this sat a little longer than I intended it to. Then when I came back to the dough, it still felt more sticky than I expected it to. So I added about another tablespoon of almond flour and just mixed it in with my hands. What I'm about to do now is divide this into six lumps. I have my baking pan covered in parchment paper. I really need to get one of those silly pat. Is that what it's called? The reusable whatchamajiggets. My hands are also wet now, and so this just helps keep the dough from sticking to me as much as possible. I have no rhyme or reason for how I'm dividing this into six. I'm really just dividing it, and then if some are a little bigger, I'll take piece of it away and put it with one that's smaller and so on and so forth. I'm kind of just dropping this onto my pan. Again, my oven has been preheating this whole time at 425. I like having things prepped even when I'm not recording a video, prior to starting. So having my pan with the parchment paper or whatever baking thing I'm using already laid out is really important for me. So here we go. What? I don't even know what that is. It's like a piece of paper or something. Anyway, you can see this one and this one are really freaking tiny. That into actual camera view. These two are tiny, so I'm going to take from this gigantic one and add to this. I think this one is okay. Take more off of this one to add to that. And take a little off of this, add to this one. And you could basically make it look whatever sensible size for you. I think I'm okay with this. Of course, you're not just gonna leave it like this. I feel like, to be honest though, I could roll this into a bagel shape and then just stick my finger in the middle of it. Then I'm gonna do it the way it says to do it on the website. So essentially, you're gonna take one of your dough lumps, roll it out into roll it out into a log. It doesn't have to be beautiful. Again, I am making this for myself and myself only. It's not restaurant level. And then just kind of mush the two ends. It's okay looking. The only thing with this is that I feel like the hole in the center is a lot larger than a regular bagel would be. I assume it'll bake up and like close up a little more, but that's what it looks like right now. I'm concerned that it's gonna look a little cray. And I like it to be, at least kind of pretty for the gram. Maybe I rolled it out too long. Maybe I just need to do this. I like this better. I'm going to do the rest like this. Actually, that more or less looks the same. All right, whatever. Leave well enough alone, right? So I'm going to roll the rest of these out. And then I'm going to grab my everything bagel seasoning and sprinkle some on top. Sprinkle pepper. It says, oh, duh, dummy face. Get my seasoning out. So this is Trader Joe's. Everything but the bagel, sesame seasoning blend. Has salt in it. Most important thing is that it has zero carbs. I'm just going to sprinkle this. Whoop. This is messy. I wonder if it would have been easier to... Let's try that. I didn't even finish my sentence, but I'm going to pour it out. And then kind of dab and slap each bagel. I used this seasoning yesterday for some salmon. The same sketchy Aldi salmon that I was talking about before. Alright, let's try this. This way I'm not like completely wasting my seasoning on the, just dropped on the parchment paper. I think I picked up as much of that as I'm gonna get. Look, starting to separate. That's working a little better. This way, whatever is left, I could always scoop up and drop in some other recipe. I'll hold on to it for the... Oh, look how pretty that is. So legit. Alright. This is back what it was. This one I'm going to try. Getting it to be as pretty as that one. It's also fine that some is on the bottom. Like, if you've gone to a legit, like, place where they sell different types of bagels, more than likely the bagels look a little wonky because they're handmade. But of course, typically they're boiled and then put in the oven. These are just going to go in the oven. Flippity slap slaps. Look how cute. I'm super content with how this is coming out. Let's just hope that it bakes up properly. I'm gonna be really sad. Alright, so you're just gonna cover all six of your pretty little bagels. Or you could also skip this if you want, or, you know, whatever you like on your bagel. Whether it's just plain or covered in seasoning like this. Do what you like. I'm not gonna feel no ways because I won't even know unless you decide to send me a picture. Or, you know, you just show up unannounced like, hey, my bagels didn't turn out like yours. Look how dope this is, though. Alright, and the last one. Try to get this. These that kind of got away. Back into the middle. Poppy seeds always all over the place. Oh, that would be nice, also, if you like. I don't know how well it would work as far as the dough itself, but like incorporated poppy seeds like directly into your dough while you're mixing it, and then just roll them out and pop it in the oven instead of doing this whole situation. All right, I think that's as good as it's going to get. There's probably seeds all on my floor, and I just cleaned the freaking house yesterday. Vacuumed and mopped and everything. All right, I'm content with this. Just try to shape it back the way it was. This is the last one, and now I'm gonna pop it in the oven. It says 12 to 14 minutes, or until the bagels are firm and golden. And so depending on your oven, that might look a little bit different. If you set your oven to 425, but that's not the actual temperature, melted stuff all over the table. It varies. It also varies depending on where you live. I live in New York City. I am not at a weird high elevation. I know that factors into how your baked goods end up turning out when you make them. Anyway, I'm gonna pop this in the oven. I'm going to set the timer for 12 minutes, but a thing that I like to do when I'm baking is have the oven light on so that I can easily like stroll by and see the progress of what's baking. So I'm going to put this in the center on the top rack, 12 minutes, and we'll see how this turns out. All right, so I've taken these out of the oven. You see my oven light is still on. I haven't even turned the oven off. This was 12 minutes, I think exactly. I realized I hadn't set the timer before I, like, moved on to washing dishes. So I set the timer for 10 because I had already been washing dishes for what I assume was 2 minutes. And so this is what they look like. This is it. I'm going to cut one open and see if the inside looks the way it does on the website that I got the recipe from. I'm going to grab a knife and a plate. Plate, knife, I'm gonna go for this. Ooh, it's hot. It's like hot. I'm gonna go for this big one over here. It's very soft. Like, not soft in the sense of like it's not gonna hold up. It's soft in the sense of like when you take some fresh baked good out of the oven and it's just magical. All right, slice as well. I'm burning my hands.
It looks like it's cooked all the way through.
Ooh.
That. Let's get nice and close on this.
Look at that. Mm-hmm. I could easily see me slapping some butter on this in the morning. Close it so you can see how nice and toasty I got on top. The other ones are a little more brown. Not sure why this was facing like the oven door, and so I guess wasn't in as much direct heat as the other bagels. That's a lie though, because look how toasty this one got. Whatever. This looks great. I'm content. I'm gonna let it cool before I try to stuff this in my mouth and tell you how it actually tastes, because right now I'm just tasting seasoning, which is not a bad thing, but you know.
All right, my battery is dying. My battery's dying. All right, so I'm gonna make this quick. So I let it cool for a few more minutes. And I'm just... I don't know how, but it tastes buttery. I don't have an explanation for that. I literally put nothing on it. It's still the plain bagel that I just sliced in half on camera. But it's really good. My only thing with this, I don't own a toaster. I could very much see, I'm looking at the cat because he's like, where's my piece? None for baby. I'd probably have to turn the oven on daily to heat this up the way that I would like it to be warm. But I think aside from that, I could do this weekly and have this ready to go. I, off the top of my head, don't know what the macros are, but I could definitely post it in the description. Happy eating, y'all. Thanks for joining me.